ciurma dolore, ma sei a Tapandai, Gigant Technology. Okay, good afternoon everybody, and it's a pleasure to be with you this afternoon. And pace su di voi, yang maksud assalamu alaikum dalam bahasa di Bunda saya.
Bahasa di Bunda apa?
Bahasa Itali.
Pace.
Pace,
pace
su,
su
di voi.
Su,
su, su, su, pace su di voi. Vieni a cacciare anche la base.
Noi piace
il Max, no problem. Ora, arriva così, arriva così. Ok, this is the title of our research that I had the pleasure to write with my fantastic colleagues. The effects of 2019 European Commission Green Transition on Transportation, Housing and Food for Ordinary Citizens. Okay, this is the abstract. Actually, the EGD means European Green Deal. It's a big project that was approved in 2019 by the European Commission to make Europe as the first continent with climate neutrality reaching by the year 2050 and net zero emission by the year 2030. Normal citizens are required to change their vehicles, all must be electric, retrofit their houses in order to keep the houses, all must be green efficient, and also adapt a new food paradigm, because the farm, what we call the normal farms with animals, they will all be shut down, because according to the European Commission, also the animals pollute our planet. I'm not going to spend much long time what is the European Green Deal. It's a big project that the European Commission approved in the 2019. The most important goal is this one, to reach the climate neutrality by 2050. And of course, to reach these important goals, the European Commission allocated 1 trillion euro plus more than 723 billion euro, because of course to reach the goals of the green transition, of course we need funds, we can just reach at zero cost. This is the problem stated. European Green Deal has been studied already by many authors from geopolitical sector, economic sector, financial sector, political sectors, scientific sector. But what I wanted to study, what are the consequences for ordinary citizens like me, like you? We are not a billionaire. We are just normal people that we live with a decent salary. What is the impact? They will benefit because the European Green Deal say we will do this project for the well-being of people. Is it true? Regarding electric vehicles, European people do not trust EVs. Why? First reason, they are too expensive compared to normal cars. They cannot afford. Insurance cost, and then the most important part is the letter E, lack of government incentives. Why? Because when in 2019 the money provided was more than 1 trillion euro, but I'm sure you're all aware what happened in February 2022, the eruption war between Russia and Ukraine, and the European Commission decided to take a political decision to sustain Ukraine militarily and of course financially as well. So all this money, the 2000 until now, Europe, all the European countries spend more than 2,200 billion euro for sustaining the war, the Ukrainian people fighting with Russia. And I give you another bad news, they are going to increase this expenditure of money. They will, the European Commission will provide more than 1,000 billion euro to who? Guess?
Israel.
Israel.
Wow, fanculo, Israel.
I mean, then, I don't know, it seems that these people in the European Commission, they like war so much. When there are wars, they like to provide funds, nothing else. Also war, they are interested. I want to avoid to make comments because I don't want to say bad words. Okay, look, all European newspapers also say bad things about that. They are not safe, they catch fire when it rains. You cannot use for more than 15 days and then before starting because the battery can cause you problem. That's why people don't trust to buy. Apart, they are damn expensive, but also because of this reason. Yes, I'm going to conclude very fast. Okay. Housing. Okay, now I'm showing you. These are some houses that have been already retrofitted according to EU directives. Do you know who to belong these houses? One belong to Cristiano Ronaldo in the Como Lake, the northern part of Italy, one of the most exclusive area. Another one belongs to George Clooney, the Hollywood actor. Of course, they don't have any financial problem to pay million and million to retrofit the house. But what about people like me, like you? I mean, they have million of euro to retrofit the house. So what? Nobody helped me, but the European Commission said, you have to pay with my own money. How? Look, just a normal building in one of the European cities like Paris, Berlin, Amsterdam, Rome, Milan, the cost will be 45,000 euro per single apartment without this public funds. How ordinary people can do? Have they print the money night time? What happened? Oh, okay. Novel food. All the farms will have to be shut down because also animals have pollute. So what is the alternative? This one. Laboratory grown meat. It's a meat created in the laboratory. All chemical. Would you trust? European people don't trust to buy this kind of food. Plus, edible insects. I never tried, honestly, and even if you give me 1 million euro, I don't think I would try because I don't know, it's not part of my tradition, you know. I never tried and I don't even trust. So, novel food also. This is what the European Commission expect ordinary people to do. Conclusion. Give me 30 seconds, I promise. At the present time, we don't know what will be the future of this green transition. Why? Because Poland, one of the EU member states, already sued the European Commission in front of the European Court. And another reason is the vice president of the European Commission resigned last year, and he was the mastermind of this European Union. So nobody knows what will happen until June 2024, when there will be new election, new European Parliament, maybe new politician, new idea. So until now, from now until June 24, the situation is like, stop. Nobody knows what is going to be the future. Look at this, this is the last graph. 28 European countries, they are not big polluters. There are countries that pollute much more. So, when we talk about climate change, global warming, it should be something that does not, why only Europe must talk about this problem? All the world should be involved, not just a small portion. I mean, even if Europe becomes totally green, and the rest of the world doesn't follow, what's the point? The planet is one. We cannot put border between countries, right, for climate change. So what I suggest and what I hope, you know that starting from November 13 until December 12, there will be the COP28. So all the world will meet in the United Arab Emirates, European countries, all Asian countries as well, to discuss the future of climate change. Because or we find a global solution, or we don't reach anywhere. If one country or few countries just take one way and the other take another way, there will not be any solution. Thank you very much. Sorry if I overboard the time.
Okay, thank you very much.